members paid themselves thousands of dollars.
Now, donors asking why. Problem Solvers investigative reporter Lori Jane Gliha is on it. Lori Jane.
Yeah, Jeremy, the combined effort to recall the governor ultimately failed, and now one group called Official Recall Colorado Governor Jared Polis is in the process of dissolving. And in its latest filing with the Secretary of State, the group reported donating some money to charity, but giving several thousand dollars to its own board members.
I'm feeling beat up.
Juliandra Fuentes says she is just misunderstood when it comes to her recall efforts against the Colorado governor.
And there's a lot of consequences to having, you know, a recall, and we planned on having a successful recall.
Fuentes chaired the committee called Official Recall Colorado Governor Jared Polis, which raised more than $100,000, but never filed a petition. It was the first time Paul Haberman ever donated to a campaign like it.
I don't think that I'd be as gung-ho to do it in the future.
Over the course of the campaign, the Secretary of State received and dismissed two formal complaints about the committee, including one from a woman who donated more than $500 and said she felt like she had been conned. But now, as the group dissolves, donors worry about how the leftover funds are being spent. State filings show two board members received gifts of $3,000 each, and a manager took $5,000.
But that doesn't seem to me, I mean, I don't think anybody should have profited individually from it.
There was a couple of board members who, you know, one has a sister who's got stage 4 cancer and she really needs it. We've got another one who, you know, her husband lost her job in oil and lost his job in oil and gas, and they now have to leave the state. They really need it.
Fuentes says the state filings mistakenly show the payments as gifts, but she says they should have been labeled as consultant fees to the board members. She says the group has more plans to give money back to volunteers, and the group also gave thousands to charity organizations.
You know, if I would have given it all to a charity, it wouldn't have been news.
So the filings have now changed to reflect the payments as consultation fees rather than gifts. The Secretary of State's office says it has 180 days to decide whether to open an investigation. And so far, no one has filed a formal complaint about this. Colorado campaign finance rules, meanwhile, show contributions to an issue committee may be donated to a charitable organization, but not used for personal purposes. I'm Lori Jane Gliha, Fox 31.
Yeah, it's interesting. Lori Jane, thank